No, I don't waste no time.
How are you doing, guys, and welcome back to a new video. Quick disclaimer before we actually start this video. This is a bit of an off-the-cuff video. It was not in the content calendar, anything like that. But I just feel like getting a video like this out of there to sort of, you know, combat a few limiting beliefs or a few, limiting beliefs is probably the best way of putting it, about having an agency, about getting clients, etc. And as you can see from the title of this video, of course, it's about how you can get clients with ease. Now, before we get into the details, there is one thing that I do need to say. When I say with ease, you know, the ease comes over time. So it's not going to be easy from the start. If you haven't got, for example, any funds available to invest into Facebook ads, then you'll need to start going into the trenches yourself, which again is still a systemized way. You know, you can definitely systemize and automate manual or organic outreach, but you know, it does require a bit more labor upfront from the start than if, for example, you run paid traffic. Okay, and like I always say to those in the coaching program as well, it's basically discipline and consistency until you can systemize and automate, okay? So discipline and consistency first, manual outreach, you know, setting up the systems yourself, etc. And then from there, you know, once you can automate and systemize, then you can actually remove yourself from that particular system, okay? Now, I'm not gonna make this one of those airy fairy videos. I will try and keep this video as practical as possible. Basically, I just see it a lot nowadays, right, in the Facebook groups, etc., or, you know, people that are in the community, or, you know, I've noticed a lot of people start to, like, comment in my community or below my post, etc., trying to, like, siphon people out of my group to, you know, basically join their bullshit program where they teach agency owners how to scale and do, you know, whatever they want. And more often than not, these are people that haven't had an agency themselves, or they've failed to make their own agency, but they have sort of generated this awareness that, okay, the online space is definitely where the money's at. And then they just, you know, think, you know what, let's just throw up a course, regurgitate what these other people are saying, and then try and sell that and try and make money in that way. Which, you know, whatever floats your boat, right? You do you. But what I just want to bring home to you guys today, or what I want you guys to take home from this video today, is how you can look at client acquisition and outreach, okay? So in my opinion, there are two things that are very important, and that is supply and demand. So what I mean by that is, if, for example, you don't have a automated or systemized way or a predictable way of getting clients, it'll be hard for you to sell high ticket. Why? Because you're going to be in the way of your own negotiation. You're going to basically have fear play a part in what you ask for the retainer. For example, let's say you've got one call all week, yeah? So for, you know, the 5 working days or the 7 working days that, you know, you're working your agency, there is one call, and it's Thursday afternoon, something like that. So all week you're thinking about this one call, you know, you think, okay, it's coming up, make or break, no other calls booked, no one else in the pipeline. This guy hops on a call with you, he says he is interested, but we need to do something about the price. Now, chances are, if that is your only call that week, you're gonna think to yourself, okay, I can say no, stick to my guns, and lose this client, or I can give him a discounted fee, and at least then, at the end of the day, I'll have something in. Because, you know, 500 a month is better than nothing, right? Or 800 a month is better than nothing, right? Whereas if this was call number 10 out of a total of, I don't know, 20 or something like that for that particular week, some client comes to you and says, listen, I'm interested, but you need to do something about the price. You'll be much more willing and much more able to say, that's not something that we can offer, you know, if that is something that you can't do, fair enough, no hard feelings, we'll move on to the next one. Why? Because it's that abundance mindset, right? We need to have an abundance mindset anyway, guys, because there's a lot of clients out there. Every day, new businesses are getting started. However, it's easier said than done, right? I've been there in the past. You know, if you've only got a couple of calls, it's hard to have that abundance mindset, and it's hard to play hardball with the negotiations. So supply and demand. If you've got a large demand for your service, you can, you know, so basically there's a limited supply. There's only a certain amount of clients you can take on, right? You know, of course that is, albeit, you know, you actually do want to provide a good service. Otherwise, you know, feel free to take on as many clients as you want if you think your service won't suffer from it. But you know, there's the supply for you and for your agency and your service is relatively limited. You can't take on 200 clients within the next month because your systems will probably break. But if there's, you know, if there's a lot of demand for it, then you can charge higher ticket for your clients. And that's literally all it comes down to, guys. Like, that is, I'm now like revealing, you know, what's behind the curtain, right? That's all it comes down to. The reason why we've been able to scale our agency, the reason why we've been able to charge higher ticket is because there's a lot of demand for it. So if we charge $1,000 a month, for example, there will be, let's say, 10 clients willing to, you know, pay that. But if we now charge $5,000 a month, there might only be like 5 clients that are willing to pay that. But 5 times 5,000 is obviously much more than 10 times 1,000, if that makes sense. Same goes for if you go really low ticket, and let's say you've got an info product or an ebook. Rather than charging $5 for the ebook, try and charge $100 for the ebook. Obviously, the value, you know, needs to be congruent with the contents of the ebook, or the price, I should say. But you know, if you charge higher ticket, yes, there'll be less people interested. But just make sure that the net outcome for you is, you know, obviously positive, or more positive than what it was if you were charging a lower ticket. So try and find that equilibrium point between your service, the price of your service, and the demand for it. So how do you create the demand is probably the next question, right? Now for me, paid traffic, you know, there's no secrecy or secret sauce, you know, it's paid traffic. We run Facebook ads for our agency. I'll get up a screenshot now. I've already got the screenshot up on my screen here as well, I know. So what I've had to do is, because of the iOS 14 update, I've obviously, you know, filtered by selection. So I think there's 82 on the screenshot that I've got now. And actually, let me just get it up. It'll probably be easier for me to get it up right away. So 82, and the cost per call is €30. So we pay €30 for a call. Not everyone is as qualified. You know, that is something I do need to mention. I think we've generated 27 clients off of the calls that, you know, have come through the agency. And we started running these particular ads on the 1st of February. So between February, March, April, May, June, which is like, well, like about five, six months, because we're in July now, we've generated 27 clients from the ads. So what does that mean? That means that we know, you know, we are getting a lot of calls booked through these advertisements. We're only, you know, only paying €30 a call. So that means that if someone comes and, you know, is difficult in the negotiations, or saying, listen, we can't afford $1,500 a month retainer, or we can't afford the rev share, or they don't want to do the rev share, anything like that, that's fine. You know, good luck with your business. We'll go on to the next one. And by having that standpoint and by being able to negotiate in that way, the quality of the calls are higher, or the quality of the clients, I should say, are higher. Our negotiation skills have increased, our sales skills have increased, because we have that abundance mindset. And we know if this client does not want to play ball, we'll move on to the next one. Okay, so supply and demand. You need to make sure that your pipeline is full, and the way we do it is paid traffic. Like I said, for those of you that can't afford to invest into paid traffic, then yeah, you will need to go down the organic outreach route, you know, emails, DMs, etc. You know, there's a lot of effective ways of doing it, but in my opinion, the most scalable way was the paid traffic. So that is why we've gone for that route. And like I said, you know, discipline and consistency before you can systemize and automate. Okay, so what we basically try and do, and what we also teach in our programs, is to remove ourselves from a lot of the systems. Okay, and I say a lot of the systems because, as you guys all know, I run the ads for my clients. That is basically how I've rebuilt and restructured the agency, for one sole reason, that is to increase the quality of our service delivery, increase the quality of the fulfillment, to make sure that our clients get better results, because I've noticed we've basically generated or we've had an increase in lifetime value ever since I've been doing this. In my opinion, I would rather have a client stay for a month longer than having to sign a new client, right? Like when I see these Instagram stories of these people saying, oh, we've signed like five clients this month, I always think to myself, like, okay, but how many stayed? You know, that for me is a much more impressive metric or a much more impressive stat if people can actually show that they're getting results with the clients and the clients are staying. Why? Because again, if you can get your clients good results, you will have basically have a leverage and a more of an authority position in the negotiations, which will enable you to also charge higher ticket for your service. And again, there's that supply and demand, right? If you can show your potential clients like, listen, these are the results that you can expect from us, or these are the results that we've gotten on average for other clients, you know, they'll be much more willing to pay more for it, you know, than basically try and negotiate you down to a lower price, because at the end of the day, they're probably just not sure if you can actually get them the results or not. If you can almost guarantee, because I never offer guarantees, that they will 10x their business in X amount of months, then, you know, you can literally just say to them, listen, if you invest $1,000 or $1,500 a month for a trainer, but you only generate an extra, I don't know, 20,000 in sales, would that be worth it for you? Chances are it probably is, because, you know, if you look at the numbers black and white, that's obviously not a big return on investment. So that is sort of how I look at it, okay? But I try and remove myself from a lot of the business processes and try and find ways to create systems and almost build a machine around myself and around the service delivery to generate me appointments on demand, generate me clients on demand, so that I can basically, first of all, get clients with ease, charge much more for it, but also, just like I said, increase my authority position in the negotiations so that I can, you know, charge whatever I want and not feel the need to lower my retainer. Because like I said, you know, if you've only got one call that week, chances are you'll probably want to do everything in your power to sign that client, because it's, you know, it's just the one call that you need to rely on. Whereas if you've got 50 clients lined up or 50 calls lined up, chances are you'll play a bit more hardball when it comes to retaining, because you know if client number one or lead number one says no, you've got 49 other leads waiting for you that could potentially all say yes, or a majority of them will say yes. Okay, so that is sort of how I look at things. In terms of the Facebook advertising, there is one thing that I do need to mention, is and which is also point number two of this video, is the relationship building aspect. Nobody is going to see your advertisement and book a call right away without any prior information or prior value. And it's the same when you know when you've got a potential partner in your life. You're not going to ask that person to marry you right away, right? You know, there's a process prior to that. You can't just walk up to a random person in the high street and say, will you marry me? You know, you need to warm that person up first, you need to nurture that person. And the same goes for relationships with, you know, with your clients. You can't just go to a random client and say, listen, this is the service that we offer, it's X amount a month, are you in or are you out? I wish it was that easy. It'll probably make the whole prospecting and outreach much more easy as well, but it's not like that. You need to give them something up front so that you can basically go into that circle of trust, in their circle of trust. For those of you that have seen Meet the Parents or Meet the Fockers, you guys will understand that reference. You know, there's the circle, and you need to be in that circle of trust to be able to be, you know, on the inside, to, you'll be able to negotiate more freely, etc. You need to get into the circle of trust of the clients, and, you know, obviously with us, our landing pages are filled with results that we've gotten for previous clients. We've got a video sales letter on there, we've got case studies, etc. That builds up that trust, and that will basically make them much more willing to hop on a call with us. Now, if you just throw up a random landing page that has a candy link, they're not gonna do that. So then you need to offer something up front. And like I said, a video sales letter is a good way. A lead magnet, a case study, a portfolio, a freebie, you know, maybe a free strategy, social media conversion rate optimization sheet. I don't know, I'm just thinking out loud here. Something along those lines, right? To get that person warmed up and to get that person to be more willing to listen to what you have to say. And that's where the Loom outreach strategy works really well as well, because you're giving value up front. You're not just expecting a call, a sales call from minute one. Okay, so moral of the story is try and increase the demand for your service. For me, that'll be by doing paid traffic. If you can't do paid traffic, if you can't afford to run Facebook ads for your agency, then you'll need to go down the organic outreach route. And from that point, it is literally just consistency and discipline, you know, being in the trenches until you can actually afford it. For those of you that are still struggling to get started with their own agency, or they want a bit more help or my guidance with their agency, just send me a message on Facebook or Instagram. My Instagram is at Joshua Daniel George. Facebook is Joshua Daniel George as well. Or what you can do is you can click on the link in the description box down below and book a call with either me or Elliot, who is the head of operations at Brandpreneur, and we can see if we can help you further with that. But with that said, I'm going to wrap up this video here. Thank you so much for watching. Like, share, comment, subscribe, and see you all in the next video.